Kak, quality.
Yeah, I'm really happy for today. Finally, I can get podium.
Mud could be said that it's causing some of the water to rise up to the surface, catching the riders out, but we carry with a big moment there around the right-hander.
Yeah, that's right. He was perhaps a little bit fortunate to get away with that.
But yesterday's race was very difficult for me, and I'm very happy with the result.
What is that?
I don't know.
GP Rookies Cup 2024 season,
Indonesia.
Welcome to the Red Bull MotoGP Rookies Cup.
Hasil Red Bull Rookies Cup 2024, syukuran podium perdana Veda, akhirnya beri kado kemerdekaan Indonesia. Pembalap Indonesia, Veda Ega Pratama, akhirnya berhasil meraih podium perdana di Red Bull Rookies Cup 2024. Veda Ega Pratama finish ketiga pada race kedua seri Spielberg yang berlangsung di Red Bull Ring, Austria. Penampilan yang taktis ditunjukkan pembalap berusia 16 tahun itu. Meski memiliki pace tinggi dan dua kali mencetak waktu lap tercepat dalam balapan, Veda cukup lama menunggu di posisi belakang dari grup terdepan. Serangan baru dilancarkan sang juara Asia Talent Cup di dua lap terakhir dari balapan selama 16 lap ini hingga sempat merebut posisi kedua jelang lap terakhir. Meski tersusul, respons apik ditunjukkan Veda dengan merebut posisi ketiga dari rider asal Argentina, Valentin Perrone, lewat manuver berani di tikungan terakhir. Podium ini dipersembahkan Veda untuk perayaan Hari Kemerdekaan Republik Indonesia yang ke-79 meski terlambat. Hari kemerdekaannya kemarin, sayangnya saya kurang beruntung, kata Veda sambil nyengir di Parc Fermé. Tak hanya merah putih yang berkibar Indonesia Raya bahkan hampir berkumandang karena Veda memimpin jelang lap terakhir. Sayangnya, karakter balapan yang agresif di kompetisi perjenjangan menuju MotoGP ini membuatnya malah diburu lawan-lawannya hingga kehilangan posisi di tikungan pertama. Karakter lintasan Red Bull Ring yang stop and go memang cukup memanjakan pembalap di belakang karena mendapat slipstream. Mundur ke tengah rombongan pembalap, Veda terjatuh saat mencoba menyalip dari sisi dalam tikungan 9 dan gagal finish. Veda tampaknya belajar dari kegagalannya kemarin. Penampilan lebih tenang ditunjukkannya dengan lebih memilih menjaga pace dan jarak dengan grup terdepan. Kendati berpeluang finish di posisi lebih baik, Veda tetap senang karena bisa menebus hasil buruknya dengan manis. Saya sangat senang, ucap pembalap asal Gunung Kidul itu masih dengan ekspresi cerianya. Bendera merah putih berkibar di Spielberg dan bersanding dengan bendera Spanyol yang wakilnya finish pertama dan kedua. Balapan dimenangi oleh Alvaro Charpe sedangkan posisi kedua diraih oleh Maximo Quiles. Veda hanya berjarak 0,3 detik dari pemenang lomba. Veda menjadi pembalap Indonesia pertama yang finish tiga besar di Red Bull Rookies Cup sejak Mario Aji pada 2021. Penampilan kompetitif sebenarnya sudah ditunjukkan Veda sejak seri perdana di Jerez pada akhir April lalu. Baru kali ini tampil di Eropa, Veda sudah berhasil merebut posisi start keempat pada kualifikasi pertamanya. Balapan debut Veda pun langsung diwarnai dengan lesatan yang membuatnya menghuni posisi kedua meski kemudian terjatuh dan gagal finish. Veda kini menempati peringkat 8 dalam klasemen sementara Red Bull Rookies Cup 2024. Mengumpulkan 77 poin, Veda terpaut 100 poin dari Charpe yang mengukuhkan posisi di peringkat pertama.
He's still lying back in 8th place in the cup at the moment, but the 15-year-old Indonesian
Race 3 of the 2024 Red Bull MotoGP Rookies Cup. Your eventual race follows through there.
Absolutely superb stuff for them. At the inside, trying to make the move there. I think it may.
Quiles.
He may have been key in 8th place.
Marouche Moodley's made a good start up from 10th to 7th as well. This is the second of the circuit into turn 6.
Back into 3rd gear here. Over the hill, up into 6th gear and 200 kilometers an hour. 126 miles an hour.
Look at this. Rico Salmela into the lead. Stop for him. Rico way wide over the rumble strip. Max Quiles out from nowhere. 4th position. Up
lap to second then. What a lap.
But it is still Sam Mellor with the advantage. Morelli up into third.
Brilliant stuff. Well, it's like what the likes of Rico and Carpe are trying to do here. But the problem is they got Quiles, Morelli.
Oh, and somebody almost lost it coming out of the chicane way back.
In Jerez at the start of the season. So that's two for two.
Navarro, Carpe's got ideas under the brakes. They go back from 200 kilometres
at the moment. But that just shows how fast the pace is here. With every
happened already this afternoon in the MotoGP race.
So it's by the pink on the back of the helmet then. Quiles leading the way down to come back. Remember last year, if you're watching Born Races, he was the pint-sized pocket rocket along with Rico Salmela.
With that, mate, it is Quiles who leads. Now, he didn't qualify on pole, but I had so much front-end chatter, I ran right off the track. At least they said I found out where the limit was.
There you go. Finding limits are going even further. Quiles going across Malaysian. Hakim Danish looking to get the whole shot into turn one. Shortcut to turn four and had to give way to the 95. Marco Morelli, who subsequently sat race over and done with his fellow Argentinian, Valentin Peroni, looked fierce after 51 of Brian Uriarte, also showing us ending up in fifth. The 83 of Alvaro Carpe on the 28 and 27 of Rico Salmela, Max was Jack Quintesan, the Thai rider, crashing out into Rico Salmela leading out front, but all the while, 28 of Max was very, very good indeed.
Now, in theory, unless he makes a mistake, Quiles cannot be beaten from here. Hello, Quiles, when it's over, Rico Salmela and Alvaro Carpe.
That was Rico Salmela there, Max Quiles.
But Hakim Danish has done it.
Now they're letting it rip for the final.
On Quiles into the last turn. Surely he's going to have a go up the inside.
I break.
Vedder raih posisi start 4 di kualifikasi RBRC Austria 2024. Red Bull Rookie Cup seri Austria memiliki 3 sesi mulai dari FP1, dilanjut FP2 dan terakhir sesi kualifikasi di mana akhirnya Salmela berhasil meraih pole position. Salmela, Carpe dan Quiles berada RI posisi top 3 dan menempatkan ketiganya di row terdepan PDA Race 2 esok dan Race 2 di hari Ahad nanti. Buat pembalap Indonesia Veda Ega Pratama, perjalanan di Austria pun naik turun. Mulai dari crash Hikside di sesi FP1 yang membuat Veda hanya berkesempatan tampil 4 lap dan mengakhiri sesi FP1 di posisi 22. Di FP2 Veda mulai bangkit dan di sesi yang menempatkan Valentin Perone Menajdi yang tercepat, Veda Ega Pratama hadir di posisi 15 dengan jarak 1,7 detik dari Perone. Di sesi kualifikasi Veda berhasil mengubah kembali peta persaingan dengan hadir sebagai pembalap tercepat keempat dengan hanya berbeda 0,344 detik dari pole sitter Salmela. Veda akan start dari posisi 4 pada race 1 dan race 2 RBRC sesi Austria 2024 ini. Wah, semoga Veda bisa memberikan kado terbaik di hari kemerdekaan RI yang jatuh hari ini ya.
Quiles, well, he certainly did a lot better in this race than he did last weekend. He stalled it on the line there.
No. He just didn't get the drive the way Brian Uriarte did. And Brian was absolutely superb on that balance of clutch and throttle that we're talking about.
Absolute rocket. Quiles, though, looking at the inside of Pratama. Round turn five. As we come onto the back straight, they've got Morelli involved the inside. Down at turn six, pushes Pratama out the way. Morelli up the inside as well. Into third spot. But Alvaro Carpe, action stations already in Rookie's Cup.
And they know that they've got to get after Uriarte because possibly let him get away.
Well, taking stock of what we got around here as well, we've got Christian Daniel Jr. His name is Christian Daniel Jr. It's a bit long on that, I've got to say. That didn't really make sense to me, but here we go. Down the final.
Dario Baggio down. Oh, no, that's not the start he wanted of the season at all.
No.
He didn't. It was Max Quiles. Superb stuff. He knew the eight of Max Quiles who lives across the line.
El Piqueras across the line. Quiles looking to assert his dominance here in Rookie's Cup in his third.
Looking good there as well in third place, but it still is the 51 of Brian.
11th spot, massive improvement from last year, but he has rejoined the race. Carter Thompson, 13, which is not where he wanted to be either.
No, and I wonder if those...
Oh, and Joel Pons as well.
The marshals looking around to see what the problem was, but, you know, it's...
It could be said that it's causing some of the water to rise up to the surface, catching the riders out, but we carry with a big moment there around the right-hander.
Yeah, that's right. He was perhaps a little bit fortunate to get away with that, but he's looking super determined, isn't he? The elbow. Carpe is off the inside.
He's down. Vader's gone down. The rider with the praying man.
Yeah, is it the damp patch or was that them being put off in fact? But, oh my goodness,
there's
catch up.
Hey!
Is well that a crash done. Or not then?
No, definitely not. That is just a superb dismount. Superb.
That's a Mamola that is, yeah, actually, for
well
the older ones.
Well done,
Pria 2024, Mario Aji dan Veda Ega Pratama main di markas KTM. MotoGP Austria 2024 bukan hanya akan menampilkan aksi dari rider elit dunia seperti Marc Marquez, Pecco Bagnaia, Jorge Martin, hingga Enea Bastianini saja. Balapan yang berlangsung di sirkuit Red Bull Ring, Spielberg sebagai markas KTM ini juga akan menampilkan pembalap Indonesia. Sebanyak 2 pembalap asal Indonesia akan turut menunjukkan aksinya di MotoGP Austria 2024 yang berlangsung. Mario Aji akan bertemu dengan rekan kompatriotnya Veda Ega Pratama di sirkuit Red Bull Ring lantaran sang rider muda itu balapan di ajang bernama Red Bull Rookies Cup 2024. Dikatakan bertemu karena agenda kelas Premier, Moto2, dan Moto3 bersamaan dengan gelaran Red Bull Rookies Cup 2024. Untuk agenda Vega di Red Bull Rookies Cup 2024 akan dimulai pada hari Sabtu, 17 Agustus 2024, hingga Minggu, 18 Agustus 2024. Dari jadwal Veda, Austria atau Spielberg akan jadi round kelima dalam ajang Red Bull Rookies Cup 2024 yang diikutinya, sementara itu musim debutnya Veda di Red Bull Rookies Cup 2024 cukup mengesankan. Sebagai pembalap Asia sendiri di ajang tersebut, juara Asia Talent Cup 2023 itu selalu meraih poin tiap roundnya. Catatan itu mengantarkan Veda berada di posisi ke-8 dalam klasemen Red Bull Rookies Cup 2024. Menariknya capaian terbaik Veda selama mengikuti ajang tersebut adalah finish ke-4 dalam round Assen beberapa waktu lalu. Menarik dinanti bagaimana aksi dari dua rider Indonesia itu ketika sama-sama mentas di Eropa.
Up into 11th spot, massive improvement from last year, but he has rejoined the race with that.
Nuriati did, and Ryan was absolutely superb on that balance of clutch and throttle. And
started in P13, which is not where he wanted to be either.
No, and I wonder if those, and I wonder if any of the damp patches which we were talking about caught out some of the guys in the MotoGP race.
Rookie's Cup in his third.
Looking good there as well in third place, but it still is the 51 of Brian Uriarte in second.
Armour behind him, the number 54 and Max Quiles. Well, he certainly did a lot better in this race than he did last week.
On the way down to the first corner.
Off like an absolute rocket. Quiles, though, looking up the inside of the back straight, they've got Morelli in fourth place.
And Max Quiles, who lives across the line at the end of...
Dead heat with Angel Piqueras across the line. Quiles looking to assert his dominance here, place as well. He's got Steve Daniel Jr. It's a bit long on that, I've got to say that. I didn't really make sense to me, but here we go.
Wanted of the season at all.
No.
He didn't have a lot of luck last year. And oh, and there, the inside. Exactly that. It is the
Lightning McQueen there. Mr. No Plan B himself. Side by side with Quiles down the back straight they come.
And this is the first time, of course, Brian Uriarte has led a Rookies Cup race because it's his first Rookies Cup race.
There we go. Quiles up the far behind him. And Alvaro Carpe. Action stations already in Rookies Cup.
And they know
around here as well. We've got Christian Daniel Jr. instead with Quiles down the back straight they come.
And this is the first time, of course, Brian Uriarte has led a Rookies Cup race because it's his first Rookies Cup.
Veda Ega Pratama jadi pemuncak rookies terbaik di Red Bull Rookies Cup 2024 setelah seri Assen. Bos KTM siap bajak digadang-gadang jadi penerus Pedro Acosta. Setelah melalui serangkaian balapan sengit di Red Bull Rookies Cup 2024, nama Veda Ega Pratama semakin dikenal di kalangan pecinta balap motor. Pembalap muda asal Indonesia ini berhasil menunjukkan performa gemilangnya dan kini menjadi pemuncak klasemen rookies terbaik setelah seri ke-4. Keberhasilan ini tidak hanya mengukuhkan posisinya sebagai salah satu pembalap muda berbakat tetapi juga menarik perhatian besar dari tim-tim papan atas termasuk KTM. Veda Ega Pratama memulai musim ini, penuh semangat dan determinasi pada seri pertama, ia menunjukkan kemampuannya dengan finish di posisi 10 besar sebuah prestasi yang cukup mengesankan untuk seorang rookies, konsistensi Veda semakin terlihat pada seri-seri berikutnya ia terus mengasah keterampilannya memperbaiki catatan waktunya dan belajar dari setiap balapan. Pada seri keempat yang berlangsung di sirkuit Assen Belanda, Veda tampil biasa meskipun menghadapi persaingan ketat dari para pembalap lain memastikan dirinya sebagai pemimpin klasemen rookies terbaik. Prestasi ini semakin mengukuhkan reputasinya sebagai pembalap yang patut diperhitungkan di ajang Red Bull Rookies Cup. Keberhasilan Veda tidak luput dari perhatian para petinggi di dunia balap motor. Terutama dari kubu KTM. Pete Bearer, CEO KTM, menyatakan kekagumannya terhadap talenta muda ini. Menurut Bearer, Veda memiliki potensi besar untuk menjadi pembalap top di masa depan. Kami telah mengamati Veda Ega Pratama selama beberapa waktu performa dan konsistensinya sangat mengesankan, dia memiliki semua yang kami cari dalam seorang pembalap muda, ujar Bearer, menambahkan. Bahwa KTM berencana untuk membajak Veda dari timnya saat ini dan memberikan kesempatan untuk berkembang lebih jauh di bawah bendera KTM.
And Max Keeles, well, he certainly did a lot better.
Absolutely superb on that balance of clutch and throttle that we're talking about before the start of the race.
Got Morelli in fourth place. Keep your eye on Lightning McQueen there, Mr. No Plan B himself, side by side. And here as well, we've got Christian Daniel Jr. in seventh place. Keeps it in the track limits. Pinned to the
line. I'm not sure
takes the whole shot in the first race of the year, but he's got Veda Pratama behind him. Mr. No Plan B himself, side by side with Keeles down the back straight they come.
And this is a fucking around an issue if he has it, because he's now up into fourth place ahead of Max Keeles. Yeah, and as we said yesterday, Rico Samella criticised himself last year for
Dinesh into the lead then. He picks the pocket of Brian Ariely. Half laps to go.
Yeah, it is two laps and a corner and a balance of clutch and throttle that we're talking about before the start.
As we come onto the back straight, they've got Morelli in fourth place. Keep your eye on Lightning McQueen there, Mr. No Plan B. Keeles down the back straight they come.
And this is the first time, of course, Brian Ariely
as well into third spot, but Pratama fights back as well. He's got Dinesh not too far. Alvaro Carp action stations already in Rookies Cup.
And they know that they've got to get out for
stock of what we got around here as well. We Dow, but his name is Christian Daniel Jr. It's a bit long on that, I've got to
say. That looking really good. Dario Boggio down. Oh, another season at all.
No.
He didn't have a lot of luck last year. And oh, exactly that. It is the 28 of Max Keeles.
Deep with Angel Piqueras across the line. Keeles looking to assert his dominance as well. Unfortunately, he had a great qualifying up into 11th spot. Another rider out as well. He will be miffed with that. He started
if any of the damp patches which we were talking about.
Nervous catching the riders out, but we carry on. It's Carpe, the number 8.
That's right, he was perhaps a little bit fortunate to get away with that, but he's looking super determined. Is he going to lead into the first corner?
Riate, did you see that? Oh my goodness, he went drifted onto the grass. Goodness for Carpe, but what about Riate?
Where's he come from? He was off the track.